encountered any situation similar to...
Oi, Peppy, you can't fix the drill. Fuck off, man. I don't want to do it. Oi, what's your problem, man? You be fucked in the head or something. Nah, I just don't want to do it because they always break down. They're always breaking down those drills. Can you, for 1 second, not be a total fuckwit? If you want to fix it, why don't you just get drill skills, you?
Because you don't become. I just spent all my skill points on Sneaky Bastard. Now deny.
Sneaky Bastard, the best team skill you can get.
Ah, the Payday Gang's drill. This thing is seen everywhere and it always just seems to break down.
You better start getting used to drills because there's a drill on literally every map excluding 4. So let's get started. Okay, into the technician tree, you have a tier level 2 skill called Hardware Expert. The base version of this means you fix the drill 25% faster, changing it from a 10 second repair time to a 7.5 second repair time. The ace version gives the drill a 30% chance to auto restart when it breaks, which means you don't have to fix it, it'll always fix itself. Next up in tier 3, you have Drill Sergeant. The base version gives you a 15% increase to the efficiency of your drill, and the ace version does another 15%, so in total it reduces the time taking to drill by 30%. Very handy. Moving up to tier 4, you've got the final drill skill, Silent Drilling. If you're going loud, this is a waste of points, however for stealth, here's how it works. A normal drill can be seen from 23 meters away and can be heard from 25 meters, if there is a line of sight. If there's an object between the drill and the guard camera or civilian, this is cut in half, making it 12.5 meters. The basic version of Silent Drilling reduces this by 65%, which means if they have eyes on the drill, they will hear it from 11.25 meters. But this is redundant because if they have eyes on the drill, they will become uncool from the sight of it, which is reduced to 22 meters, before becoming uncool from the sound of it, which is 11.25. However, if there's an object between them, they need to be within 5.625 meters to become uncool. If you're prepared to spend another 8 points, you can ace Silent Drilling, which makes it completely silent, and guards, cameras, and civilians have to see the drill to become uncool, which is 22 meters. But you most likely already knew that, so let's move on to the nitty gritty. It may appear drills seem to just randomly break, but that's not true at all. Drills are programmed to break between 1 to 3 times, and this is determined upon placing the drill. There are no skills that improve your chances for this, so each drill will break by itself 1, 2, or 3 times. This is of course excluding when a cop shuts off the drill. You can figure out how often a drill is going to break by knowing these rules. Between 0 and 16.7%, the drill can never break. Once you pass that, if the drill breaks between the 16.7 and the 30% mark, then you have a drill that will break 3 times. Each break will occur 16.7 to 30% after the previous one. If the drill breaks between 25 and 45%, then you have a drill that's going to break twice, and the second break will occur between 25 to 45% after the previous one. If you can get past the 45% mark without a break, you have a drill that will break exactly one time, and this time will happen anywhere between 50 to 90%. But once that break occurs, the drill will never break again. The 90 to 100% mark is a break-free zone. Those paying attention might have noticed the overlap between 25 to 30%. This is what I refer to as a gray area, since you don't know how many times it's going to break, and you'd be unlucky for it to break here. Let's move on to the different types of drill times in the game. In total, there are 7 unique drill times. Starting from fastest to longest, you have 60, 120, 180, 200, 240, 300, and 360. With Drill Sergeant Ace, these times become 42, 84, 126, 140, 168, 210, and 252, respectively. Things under the 60 and 42 second categories include things such as cages from Election Day 2, Shadow Raid and Meltdown, the train carriages from Train Heist, the gates from Hotline Miami Days 1 and 2, the SWAT van found on Hoxha Breakout Day 1, the containers from Bomb Dockyard,
and the doors and Hoxton breakout day 2. Next up, 120 to 84 second items, the truck from Firestarter day 1 and Bomb Dockyard, the diamond vault when it goes loud, and the train wagon from Bomb Forest. 180 to 126 second items, small safes that are non-Titan, security doors, the evidence locker from Firestarter day 2, the watchdogs gate on day 1, and big bank and bank cages. In the 200 and 142nd category, we have the one item, armored trucks from the armored transport heist. 240 to 168 second items, small safe Titan, small tall safe non-Titan, and the server barrier from Firestarter day 2. 300 to 210 second items, you got the large square safes, non-Titan, and the large tall safes that are also non-Titan, but then you have the small tall safes that are Titan. Finally, 360 to 252 second items, large square safes Titan, large tall safes Titan, and thermal drills, including but not limited to bank heist, go bank train heist, Hotline Miami Day 2, Hoxton Revenge, Election Day Plan C, and many more. Moving on to special mentions, Bomb Dockyard containers and Bomb Forest carriages programmed to never break. The Beast from Big Bank is affected by Drill Sergeant and has a default time of 300 seconds. Hoxton Breakout Day 2 doors are programmed to only break once, and that will happen sometime between the 50 and 90% mark, giving you 30 or 21 seconds to defend or, in the case of the evidence locker objective, pick the door without lockpicking skills. Finally, we have the BFD, or the Big Fucking Drill, described to be the first drill that doesn't break, although it isn't actually a drill, it's a fucking plasma cutter or something like that. However, ironically enough, every other drill on Golden Green is programmed not to break and are all 60 or 42 seconds long. The BFD itself, however, it takes 420 seconds without assets. With the engine optimization asset, it goes for 360 seconds. With the additional engine power, it goes for 300 seconds. However, if you get engine optimization and additional engine power, you lose the benefit of additional engine power and the time will be 360 seconds. So if you're gonna get something, put your points into additional engine power, so it's 300 seconds. I briefly mentioned the auto restart skill at the beginning, but I'm gonna elaborate. The moment a drill acquires the auto restart skill, whether it be from the moment it was placed or if someone with drill skills upgrades it, it will have already evaluated if that chance has worked. Meaning, if the 30% chance was successful, it will always restart within 5 to 20 seconds, regardless if the drill breaks down by itself or if a cop turns it off. There is, however, one exception to this, and that is the Commissar's helicopter from Hotline Miami Day 2. If the heli disables the drill, then it has to be manually restarted. On another note, just like everything in this game, the drill can be affected by desync if you're client. That's pretty much everything. This video has gone on way longer than I expected, so to finish up, I've created some images that sum up most of the points in this video. The completely overdrill image, which comes in the countdown edition, which is useful for your everyday heisting, and the count-up edition, which is useful for speedrunners such as myself. Still too much information? I made the drill brake monitor image, which shows you where on the drill monitor the brake points are. And finally guys, a lot of work went into making this video. I've really been trying to step up my production quality and even got a new microphone for it, so any and all support is greatly appreciated. Thanks guys.